Hello, everyone. Today we are doing lesson 82 review of lessons 63 and 64 and the correlating chapter text of chapter 8, The Journey Back, section 5, The Undivided Will of the Sonship. Shall we begin? Alex?
Can you be separated from your identification and be at peace? Disassociation is not a solution. It is a delusion. The delusional belief that truth will assail them and they do not recognize it because... Let me read that again. The delusional belief that truth will assail them and they do not recognize it because they prefer the delusion. Judging truth as something they do not want, they perceive their illusions which block knowledge. Help them by offering them your unified mind on their behalf, as I am offering you mine on behalf of yours. Alone we can do nothing. But together our minds fuse into something whose power is far beyond the power of its separate parts. By not being separate, the mind of God is established in ours and as ours. This mind is invincible because it is undivided.
So what that's talking about, folks, is that when you choose to collaborate with Holy Spirit and God and Jesus, you are choosing to intertwine your mind with theirs, to choose to believe what they are placing before you as being the absolute truth. And in so doing, you are extending that truth to your brothers and laying that truth before your brothers. And what it was talking about here is that when our brothers or even ourselves are trying to disassociate from something that does not equate to what we've been taught to believe in as being the truth. And for some reason, equate is not the correct word either. It's like when everything we've been taught to believe in to be true is conflict. That's the word. When what we're being told brings up conflict within us because it's not in alignment with what we've been taught, we will try to disassociate from it and we will choose to continue believing in our delusions, our belief in what is not true. And it is because in those moments we prefer the delusion because we are in such fear that to let go of those things we've been taught to believe will mean that we are going to lose something. And all of us do this, folks. I've done it. Alex has done it. All of us have done it. Been afraid to let go of something for fear that we're going to lose something. Not recognizing that it's in the letting go that it is replaced with something better. And it is that we are offering to our brothers when we extend this collaborated truth. When we collaborate with Holy Spirit and God and Jesus to walk with them on this journey and to take our guidance from them and not from our brothers outside of us. And we extend what we are being shown and learning within ourselves. When we extend that to our brothers, we are laying before them the truth as we know it to be. And it's up to them in that moment to choose for themselves. They can either keep picking their delusion or they can choose to accept what's been handed to them. Please continue.
The undivided will of the sonship is the perfect creator being holy in the likeness of God, whose will it is. You cannot be exempt from it if you are to understand what it is and what you are. By the belief that your will is separate from mine, you are exempting yourself from the will of God, which is yourself. Yet to heal is still to make whole. Therefore, to heal is to unite with those who are like you, because perceiving this likeness is to recognize the Father. If your perfection is in Him and only in Him, how can you know it without recognizing Him? The recognition of God is the recognition of yourself. There is no separation of God and His creation. You will realize this when you understand that there is no separation between your will and mine. Let the love of God shine upon you by your acceptance of me. My reality is yours and His. By joining your mind with mine, you are signifying your awareness that the will of God is one.
Yeah. When you choose to join with them and collaborate with them, you choose to become of one mind. And in truth, it's even one body. Because you are choosing to use your vessel, the body that you are residing in, as the vehicle of exchange. And in so doing, you are choosing to share that vessel with God, with Jesus, with Holy Spirit. As they use that vessel, as you do, to extend this truth to your brothers. Sounds a little twisted there, doesn't it? But that's the picture I keep getting. You get this, the Trinity within you. It's the connection of heart, mind, and body into one vehicle, one being, to move forward and do His will. To become one aspect. It's a trippy picture that I'm being shown here. It's only when we connect and join in with them that we will heal within. When we choose to accept what they lay before us is when we heal. I know this to be true. Because when I accepted what they laid before me, I was healed. I was healed of two forms of cancer, diabetes, high blood pressure, irritable bowel syndrome, migraines, and a lot of other crap, asthma. A lot of the things that I had been finding issues with in my life, I was healed of. I live in peace and joy now. I don't live in pain and suffering and misery. So it's only when I turned within to them that I healed. And I did it without medications and without surgeries. This is how I know what I am saying is the truth for me. Was the full healing of my body, my mind, and my spirit. Of all I had been taught to think and believe to be true. And all disease through it. Please continue.
God's oneness and ours are not separate because His oneness encompasses ours. To join with me is to restore His power to you because we are sharing it. I offer you only the recognition of His power in you, but in that lies all truth. As we unite with Him. Glory be to the union of God and His holy sons. All glory lies in them because they are united. The miracle we the miracles we do bear witness to the will of the Father for His Son and to our joy in uniting with His will for us.
Exactly. As we choose to join in collaboration with Holy Spirit, God, and Jesus, as we choose that collaboration, we choose that oneness with them to become one. And as we do, we restore His power unto ourselves. And in so doing, we are able to then share that understanding and that joy and that power with our brothers to help them understand what it is that they do so they may get their power back too. It's only as we unite in understanding these things that we've chosen that we are responsible here and accept that we can join in collaboration with God and Holy Spirit. It's only in accepting that responsibility that we're able to do so. And in doing so, God's will for us is fully accepted and known. And nothing will ever take that away from us again, no matter the circumstances we experience. Please continue.
When you unite with me, you are uniting without the ego, because I have renounced the ego in myself and therefore cannot unite with yours. Our union is therefore the way to renounce the ego in you. The truth in both of us is beyond the ego. Our success in transcending the ego is guaranteed by God, and I share this confidence for both of us and all of us. I bring God's peace back to all His children because I received it of Him for us all. Nothing can prevail against our united wills because nothing can prevail against God's.
Exactly. So it's as I was just saying, you know, when we choose to join in collaboration with God and Holy Spirit to create that Trinity within ourselves, we are uniting without the ego in place. We are uniting with one mind. The ego thought system, the ego thought and beliefs are no longer viable or valid to us. They don't exist. We no longer choose what does not exist. We only choose what is real. And it's in this way that we are able to let go everything we've been taught, of recognizing what is and what is not, of looking at these things we've been taught and letting them go. Please continue.
Would you know the will of God for you? Ask it of me who knows it for you, and you will find it. I will deny you nothing, as God denies me nothing. Ours is simply the journey back to God, who is our home. Whenever fear intrudes anywhere along the road to peace, it is because the ego has attempted to join the journey with us and cannot do so. Sensing defeat and angered by it, the ego regards itself as rejected and becomes retaliative. You are invulnerable to its retaliation because I am with you. On this journey, you have chosen me as your companion instead of the ego. Do not attempt to hold on to both, or you will try to go in different directions and will lose the way.
Absolutely. And what that's talking about here, folks, is You can't hold two belief systems here. You have to choose one or the other. You know, all our lives we've been taught to hand away our free will and to hand away our ability to choose for ourselves to someone else, to give that responsibility to someone else, to be afraid to take responsibility for the choices we make. But in this, we are being shown we have no other choice but to make that choice and decision. We have to choose to be responsible for the choice we make in this moment. And that very first opening question to you, would you know the will of God for you? And then the next, ask it of me who knows it for you and you will find it. Ask of Holy Spirit and He will tell you the truth of it. He will tell you what God's will for you is. But you got to ask Him. Always comes back to asking. And I know growing up it sucked to have to ask for something because you were always told no. No, you can't. No, you're not allowed. Everything was a prohibition. You were prohibited from doing this, prohibited from doing that. And it's not the same here. When you ask, you actually get an answer. And not a, because I said so. And as it says there in the next sentence, He will deny you nothing. I will deny you nothing as God denies me nothing. You ask, He will give. But you have to ask. And as it was saying here, you know, when fear intrudes anywhere along the road to peace, it is because the ego has attempted to join the journey with you. You have chosen in that moment to think or try and believe that something is true that is not. Maybe somebody has said something, something's happened out there, and you're thinking to judge it in some way. And you get that sense of fear, anxiety. When those thoughts come up, look at them. Understand what's happening. And a lot of times you'll recognize it as just your ego trying to make you feel fearful in those moments, wanting to join the journey. Ask and you shall receive. Ask for understanding of what was happening in that moment and to have it be released. Let it go. And it's true here what it says, you know, in those moments, if you choose to latch onto that egoic thought that's coming in your mind, that's having you feel that fear, you'll feel a sense of defeat and anger with yourself. Like you're a failure, that you just can't get it. This course doesn't work for you, all that kind of stuff. And you'll feel as if, you know, you're being rejected and abandoned in some way. And it's not true. It's because you're choosing to believe something that's not true with an ego thought. You have to recognize when that stuff happens, go within and look to Holy Spirit and say, what is it I'm misperceiving? And as it comes up, instead of picking and choosing what you think it might all be for, ask for clarity. Okay, what is it you would have me see here? Please make it very clear so I cannot misperceive it again. Show me the truth so I can heal. I don't like this pain and suffering. I want to heal this. Please continue. I believe it's the last paragraph.
Yes. The ego's way is not mine, but it is also not yours. The Holy Spirit has one direction for all minds, and the one he taught me is yours. Let us not lose sight of his direction through illusions, for only illusions of another direction can obscure the one for which God's voice speaks in all of us. Never accord the ego the power to interfere with the journey. It has none, because the journey is the way to what is true. Leave all illusions behind and reach beyond all attempts of the ego to hold you back. I go before you because I am beyond the ego. Reach therefore for my hand because you want to transcend the ego. My strength will never be wanting, and if you choose to share it, you will do so. I give it willingly and gladly because I need you as much as you need me.
Thank you. Very quickly, you come to understand the differences between your ego voice and Holy Spirit's voice, in the way your ego mind is thinking and the way Holy Spirit thinks. And as you choose to join in collaboration with Holy Spirit and God, you will find yourself letting go of those illusions and being able to see through them clearly. Not just your own, but even the ones your brothers are still choosing to believe in. And to see the truth of what it is they do, and they do it all unknowingly. You know, as the saying goes, forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. And in that same way, we are here to forgive them for not knowing what they do, just as we had to forgive ourselves. This is why we are to be the example, folks. Once you get it, you become the example of it by choosing to live it and be that example, to not get caught up in their choices to believe. And as it says here, he needs us as much as we need him, him being Holy Spirit, Jesus, God. And it's only when we choose to go within and collaborate with them, join with them, that we will heal. And through our healing, heal our brothers and heal the world. All right, that was Chapter 8, The Journey Back, Section 5. The Undivided Will of the Sonship. Let's continue on to the lesson of the day, which is lesson 82, review. And remember, folks, the review of this lesson, these lessons, is to do one for the morning, one for the evening or afternoon, and throughout the day to be pulling in from both of those lessons throughout the day, in correlation to whatever it is you're experiencing and going through your day, to incorporate the lessons within your day and to see how they are true, to do the work. All right, Alex?
I just want to say that when I was doing these lessons, it worked very well for me to apply them both into one. Like, for example, our two lessons today is review 63 and 64. And I would apply them in specific situations, any situation that would bring away my peace or that I was confused, or sometimes I would just apply it to everything and, you know, see what happens.
Yeah.
So, for example, let's say somebody cuts me off in traffic. I might say, The light of the world brings peace to every mind through my forgiveness. Let me not forget my function.
Ooh, I like it. Nice.
So that's just something that worked for me.
There you go. There's an example of a way to use it as you're going through your day.
All right, so I'll go ahead and read these.
Okay.
We already know it's lesson 82. We've already said it several times.
Okay.
The light of the world brings peace to every mind through my forgiveness. My forgiveness is the means by which the light of the world finds expression through me. My forgiveness is the means by which I become aware of the light of the world in me. My forgiveness is the means by which the world is healed together with myself. Let me then forgive the world that it may be healed along with me. Some suggestions for specific forms for applying this idea are, now here in these it has just name and bracket. I'll use Sabrina, just easier. Let peace extend from my mind to yours, Sabrina. I share the light of the world with you, Sabrina. Through my forgiveness, I can see this as it is.
Yeah, he has to constantly forgive me, folks, because I smoke cigarettes. And that's one of those things that he's on a daily basis, hour by hour, having to look at and try and forgive me for.
I figure she's still smoking because I haven't forgiven it enough. So I keep forgiving and forgiving and forgiving and forgiving. And maybe someday I'll forgive it away.
Or I'll quit. One of the two.
Right.
So, you know, it's recognizing that in these moments that, you know, remember that you are the one picking and choosing everything here. You are the one responsible for whatever it is you think you are seeing and perceiving. And that you have the choice to decide for yourself how you are going to experience whatever it is. And that as you look on and forgive yourself for the way you were taught to think and believe, you start to see the light of the world within yourself. And then you can see the light of the world within your brothers. And so it's reminding you here that the light of the world brings peace to every mind through you and through your forgiveness of yourself and through yourself by forgiving your brothers. Continue, please.
So the second part of the review is, let me not forget my function. I would not forget my function because I would remember myself. I cannot fulfill my function if I forget it. And unless I fulfill my function, I will not experience the joy that God intends for me. Suitable specific forms of this idea include, let me not use this to hide my function from me. I would use this as an opportunity to fulfill my function. This may threaten my ego, but cannot change my function in any way.
Absolutely. And with that, speaking of folks, just a reminder is that our egos would have us believe that we're the ones in the wrong, that we need to be fearful, shameful, feel guilty, all of that bullshit. And when all of that stuff comes up, it's to recognize it in the moment that it's coming up, that our ego minds are saying these things to us, or our brother is trying to say these things to us to instill guilt, shame, and fear. And for us to remember that we can choose for ourselves what we want to do and what resonates for us. And to ask in those moments to turn within and say, let me not forget my function here, Holy Spirit. Please, let me be and bring the light of the world through me, through my forgiveness of whatever it is I think I'm perceiving here. Let me forgive this for what it is not. Sounds funny, I know. Let me forgive this for what it is not. But that is basically what you're doing. And every time that stuff comes up, go within, turn within. Don't go to your brothers, go inward and look at it. Look at what you're thinking, the emotions you're feeling, and then your body's physical responses, and question all of it. Why am I doing this? Why am I thinking this? Why am I believing this? And say, if this is, you know, what is my function in this moment? How is it that the light of the world brings peace to every mind through my forgiveness? How am I not remembering this? Bring yourself back to center with it. Recognize that you're the one with the misperception and you get to choose. You get to ask for correction and choose whether or not you want to accept that correction. Power is in your hands, folks. It's always been there, but you just never freaking realized it. You've been taught to overlook it and to ignore it as if it had never been. Same with free will. Your right to pick and choose. You've been taught to believe that you do not have a choice and you're not allowed to have a choice. You've always had the choice. And you are constantly making choices and not even recognizing it when you do. Anytime you choose to follow what another's dictating, to blindly believe something without questioning it, you're making a choice. You're making a decision. And you do it subconsciously. All right, that was Lesson 82's review of Lessons 63 and 64. The light of the world brings peace to every mind through my forgiveness, and let me not forget my function. With the correlating chapter text of Chapter 8, The Journey Back, Section 5, The Undivided Will of the Sonship. Please do the work, ladies and gentlemen. Please do the work. Only you can do it. We say this every time. I'm pretty sure it's starting to dawn on you that it is you doing it. And you're realizing that it's only you that can choose. So I don't have to keep saying it. But I keep getting told by them, say it, repeat it. So I am. Everything we go through is for our benefit. Anytime something's being brought up in front of you, a thought, a memory being jogged, is being brought up for you to look at so you can heal the misperception that you have about it. Don't just overlook it. Recognize that when this stuff comes up, it's not to be pushed away and buried again. It's to be looked at because you have an attachment to it. All these teachers that keep telling you, ignore it, fake it till you make it. Don't look at those thoughts. Don't look at those things from the past. The past isn't real. It never happened. Da 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 da. You know, it's a concept misperceived what they're talking to you about right there. They're not understanding fully what the lesson's talking about. They're not understanding fully that what you think and believe happened isn't what really happened. That what you experienced, you overlaid judgments on. Judgments and beliefs of what you were taught to think and believe happened in those moments. Or that you choose to think and believe happened in those moments. It's when we stop questioning and start blindly following and believing that we have these concepts misperceived, that we do not bother to truly look at what it is that's being said to us. We just want to have our hand held and be told what to do, when to do it, and how to do it. and believe that that's going to fix everything and we're going to be happy, joyful, and rich and famous or whatever it is. And it just doesn't work that way, folks. It's only when we choose to actually do this work and to really look at what's being put before us that healing occurs in growth. That we figure out who the fuck it is we really are within these shells. That we're not our bodies, we're the soul within them, we're that the light within. All right. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Sabrina Reyenga.
And I am Alex Reyenga.
Hugs, love, light, and blessings on your journey, my brothers. You are loved. We love you. Be the light you're meant to be. Be the light of the world. Be the light we know you to be. Blessings on your journey. You are loved. We love you. Be the light.